CarClear TV for the premiere of our new show, All Inbox. We've got Daniel here to answer your questions, and if you have a question, you can write to allinbox@carclear.com. Daniel, thanks so much for being on our first show.
No sweat. I got nothing else to do.
All right, the first question is from Michael from Georgia. I would like to ask about a time that you felt the most on tilt or frustrated at the poker table. Can you describe the situation along with any consequences or lesson learned from the incident?
This happened several times. I'll just describe it in terms of like what happens. It's generally the World Series of Poker. Because the World Series of Poker, and I'm not talking about the main event, I'm talking about like, say, maybe the third or fourth weekend, you have so much built up just frustration and steam, and just you're so just drained of energy because you're working every day 14, 15 hours a day. And I would say in 2005, after being Player of the Year, I went like 8 straight tournaments and just got like, you know, really bad beats and just kind of like get to a bobble point. And when you're really frustrated, that's when like I lose a hand and maybe the fist hits the ground, but nothing too crazy. I mean, I usually keep my composure pretty well. Just when my stress level's at a high at the World Series of Poker, I can snap.
Do you think that 2005 year really helped you, I mean, increase your endurance because you had to deal with all those bad beats? And
not really, because because I was getting knocked out of these tournaments in 2005, I had a lot of free time. last year was the most grueling thing I've ever done. I cashed 8 times and I was close like 3 other times. Lost weight, you know, wasn't as healthy. Cost me in the main event because I showed up to the main event actually sick. So it's a fine line of pushing yourself to the point where you want to do as well as possible, win Player of the Year, and also keeping sane. Because I tell you, the first 2 weeks, I'm like, hey, how are you guys doing? Whatever. Then, like, the last 2 weeks, I'm like, what do you want? You know, it's just total change in personality because you just drain. You love it going in. You hate it near the end. When you're done, you can't wait to go back.
Gotcha. All right, we have a strategy question. Martin from Wisconsin writes, I played a deep stack tournament this summer in Vegas at the Venetian. In the first level of the tournament, this situation came up. My opponent and I both had around 15,000 in chips with the blinds at 2550. I raised to 250 with pocket kings and got re-raised.
250?
And got.
That's not small ball. Okay, go on.
It's not small ball, you're right.
Sheesh.
I got re-raised from the small blind to 1100. I'd been pretty aggressive, so I re-raised to 3,500. He thought for a second, and he went all in. It didn't seem like he would do this with jacks or lower, maybe queens. Can I fold here?
Yes, you can absolutely fold here, yeah. You still have enough chips. You have to ask yourself, what kind of hands would this guy actually have, right? First of all, I hate the way you played the hand in every street. I mean, every decision made, I don't like. You have to think, you're making such a very large raise to 250. That's 5 times the blind. If someone's willing to re-raise you there from the small blind, that's a sign of strength. Now you've re-raised them, and they re-raise you back? There's usually one hand they're going to have, and that's 2 aces. So I don't profess that it's a good idea to fold kings very often before the flop, but the situation as described to me, it would seem like, with your chip stack the way it is, be the right play was to fold there.
Had you made a smaller raise pre-flop, and he re-raised you, do you like flat calling there?
Yes. I much prefer the flat call because, again, if you don't know a lot about your opponent, right? So you don't know what types of hands he'll re-raise with, you have to ask yourself, okay, if I re-raise this guy and he re-raised me, what will I do? So if you're going to play the hand aggressively with kings, you have to already think ahead of like, am I willing to go all in with this or will I fold to another bet? And if you don't know the answer to that question, call is the best option because you have position. That's really important. Anytime you have position, it's an okay thing to see a flop.
Thank you so much, Daniel.
You got it.
Chris Tarnett with Daniel Negreanu for the first episode of All Inbox. If you have questions, send us to allinbox@carclear.com.